Welcome back, everybody, to another edition of 2K23 Universe Mode. We're here with Monday Night Raw, and we have a huge announcement concerning this match. We'll get to that after the introductions.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring from Atlanta, Georgia, weighing in at 220 pounds, Austin Theory.
So here comes Austin Theory coming down to the ring for some one-on-one action. Well, guys, again, welcome to Monday Night Raw. We're on the road. We're over halfway to SummerSlam. We've got six shows done, six to go. And this one will be a barn burner because we have a huge announcement. This coming SummerSlam, we'll have the Money in the Bank matches. Yes, we'll have two Money in the Bank ladder matches, one for the men, one for the women. And this is a qualifying match for that opportunity. First, we have A-Town Down Austin Theory. And here comes the second competitor. That man is Sami Zayn.
And his opponent from Montreal, Quebec, Canada, weighing in at 212 pounds, Sami Zayn.
So, of course, Austin Theory, he is 1-0 here in our Years Mode. And Sami Zayn is 2-1. So everybody in the qualifying matches for the Money in the Bank are going to be positive in the win and loss records. So again, Theory with 1-0 and Sami Zayn with 2-1. And we're going to have a women's match later on to figure out the first women in the women's Money in the Bank match. And of course, it won't be right. We just have all these on Raw. So we're going to have three matches for the men's side and the women's side here on Monday Night Raw in the next coming 3 weeks. And then on SmackDown, gonna have the same kind of thing. So we're gonna have a qualifying match as one of our featured matches coming on SmackDown as well. As we see, oh, Sami Zayn with a springboard tornado DDT starting off things hot. And he's gonna go for another one. Well, Sami Zayn, of course, part of the new tag team with Shinsuke Nakamura, calling themselves the Heart and Soul of Monday Night Raw, the Heart and Soul. But nevertheless, Sami Zayn could be on the track to go to SummerSlam for Money in the Bank. I want to keep calling it Money in the Bank, but nevertheless, it's going to SummerSlam for the Money in the Bank ladder match. And there's a Hurricane Rana to take down one of the most up and coming future stars, future prospects here on Monday Night Raw, known as Austin Theory, with a German suplex and planting Sami Zayn right on the back of his head, back of the neck on that German. But Sami Zayn, former Intercontinental Champion, former United States Champion, Tag Team Champion. And of course, he's been in Money in the Bank as well. I believe, I think he has been. I'm not quite sure. Oh my God, what a suplex. I think Theory's leg was caught on that apron as well. So the match has spilled to the outside. And we're going to these matches that happened earlier on tonight. Rey Mysterio got a win over Marseille. We'll get to that in just a little bit here. A little shenanigans happened. China beat Natalya in what was called the first women's qualifier for the women's Money in the Bank. So China will be in the Money in the Bank matchup. Shinsuke Nakamura, the other half of Heart and Soul, with Sami Zayn defeated Axiom 1-1. And then the Heart Foundation, Jim the Anvil Neidhart, and Brett the Hitman Hart defeated the new tag team here of Pretty Deadly, Elton Prince, Kit Wilson. And Wes Lee got his first win here against the big and, well, frankly, not monstrous, I guess, Veer Mahant, as Wes Lee got the victory. And finally, Alexa Bliss got the win over Tiffany Stratton. Alexa Bliss, I think that may be her first win here in Universe Mode. I think she wasn't crazy in the standings. Let me take a look here. Alexa Bliss, she has 0-2 before that win, so now she has 1-2. And there's a sidewalk slam by, look at this, by Austin Theory. Now, oh, over the knee, just playing the back of the neck, goes for the cover. 1-2, and shoulder up by Sami Zayn. So there you go, China being qualifying for the, oh, there is that TKO into the knee as well. So Sami Zayn in a battle. Where could this be it for Sami Zayn? Oh. Awesome Theory sees getting frustrated here. He wants to get that win to move on to SummerSlam. So like I was saying, Shayna being the first woman to qualify for that Money in the Bank. So that's already a hard hitter, harder a big name in that Money in the Bank come SummerSlam for the women. And now Austin Theory, oh, looking for the elbow, got missed there. Sami Zayn got back to his feet. Now this combination of strikes and the uppercut. Oh, an elbow right to the side of the head, and Theory never out of the game here. Goes for a big back suplex, just plants Sami Zayn. Now Theory, oh, easy way for Sami Zayn to get back. Maybe a big risk maneuver here from Theory, and there's a suicide. Oh, crash and burn. Zayn moving out of the way just in time, and you can see Austin Theory almost scorpioning on the outside, legs almost hitting the back of his neck there. So ooh, right into the post goes Theory in a bad way after that crash. He did push off Sami Zayn with his feet right there. Ooh, a little turnabout is fair play as both guys try to get the upper hand here on the outside, and into the barricade goes Theory. Theory and Sami Zayn just happy to take the victory. That's me. If he gets a count of victory, he goes straight to SummerSlam in that Money in the Bank matchup. He doesn't care if it's count out. I wouldn't care. I'm going to the second biggest pay-per-view of the year. Oh, Koji clutch coming. Is he gonna? Oh, he got it hooked, but Austin Theory is right near the ropes. He just has to reach out. Koji clutch applied, but Austin Theory, and oh, he's just gonna muscle out of it, an elbow right to the side of the face. And back to his feet, and now attacks the left knee of Sami Zayn. Look at this. Turns him around. Oh, into. Oh, that elbow right to, or a forearm right to the chin. And now, look at this. He's going to go for that TKO again, right into the knee. And A-Town down. 2-3 is moving on to SummerSlam.
Here is your winner.
So Theory getting the victory here tonight. And what a win it was against A-plus Sami Zayn. But there it is. Austin Theory is the first man to qualify for the Money in the Bank matchup for the men. We're going to have the next matchup on SmackDown for the first entrant for SmackDown. But also, like I said, Chyna winning the match earlier on against Natalya to move on to the first competitor for the Money in the Bank matchup for the women. And now we're moving on to some tag team action with Drew Gulak and John Cena.
The following contest is a tornado tag team match. On the way to the ring, at a combined weight of 444 pounds, Drew Gulak and John Cena.
Well, John Cena, Drew Gulak, one of the new teams here, moving on to WWE 2K23. Not on the best starts I've ever seen. They're 0-1 right now, and they're going to face off against the new team of the corporate club. I don't know what to call them, the chosen ones. I really have no name for these guys, but it's going to be AJ Styles and Chad Gable, who have been great, have been absolutely fantastic in terms of singles matchups. But this is their first type of test in tag team action. Here comes Chad Gable.
First, from Minneapolis, Minnesota, weighing in at 202 pounds, Chad Gable!
And this tag team really, really impresses me, because if you talk about one of the most underrated superstars in not only today's WWE, but all of WWE in all of its years, Chad Gable has to be up there. And you think about Owen Hart, you think about the people like that who have, you know, William Regal, I would say, is even part of that, who you know, just got on the cusp of maybe getting a world championship, but they're just so impressive in the ring, you can't help but respect them. And then they have a tag team partner like this, the phenomenal AJ Styles.
from Gainesville, Georgia, weighing in at 218 pounds, the phenomenal AJ Styles.
And then you have AJ Styles, an overall world class, world traveled athlete here in sports entertainment and wrestling all together. He's wrestled in Japan, he's wrestled in Europe, Australia, you name it, you name the company, he's probably been a world champion in it. And for someone like Chad Gable to not only learn from AJ Styles, but of course, you gotta think about the other person in the corporate club, or the chosen ones, the chosen club, the corporate, whatever, Vincent Kennedy McMahon. Vincent McMahon is pretty much the, I guess, manager or like third person in this group. So for Chad Gable to be learning from these two men, I think you gotta think, you gotta see a world championship in his near future. But right now, they're looking for some tag team gold, and they're facing Drew Gulak and John Cena here tonight. Kind of the same type of dynamic, if you would, you know, so say, is like Drew Gulak. I mean, say what you want, he's a former United States champion in our universe mode, and he is one of the most talented wrestlers in the back. Wait a minute, look at this, Drew Gulak. Oh, he's gonna look for a power bomb, but it's gonna be a little hard to call, as it's pretty much a fatal four-way type scenario, as all four guys are in the ring at the same time. So it's gonna be tough to call. But like I was saying, Drew Gulak, he's one of the most impressive wrestlers on the WWE roster, and of course, being a former United States champion, just the absolute, you know, not physique, or technique. I was looking for a technique that Drew Gulak possesses, and to be learning from one of the, maybe the best sports entertainer, the best person in WWE ever, John Cena. I mean, that's arguable, but he's pretty much up there. To be learning from John Cena, I think you also gotta look, oh, what a minute, oh, go AJ Styles! Just caution to the wind, throwing caution to the wind and moving, and now look at this, Drew Gulak! Taking out Chad Gable on the outside, DDT by Styles. Like I said, it's gonna be a little hard to call, but again, maybe similar dynamics between these two teams, but it looks like the youngins, I guess, the more upstarts, Chad Gable and Drew Gulak fighting on one side, and then of course the veterans, the carriers of the team, if you will, AJ Styles and John Cena fighting on the opposite side of the ring. And you see now on the table now, Chad Gable goes to the outside. Wait a minute. And a big time sit down powerbomb from John Cena. Of course, Tornado tag team rules in this match, because regular tag team matches suck in these games. Smile. Wait a minute. Drew Gulak. No. Chad Gable reverses into a chop block, and in goes AJ Styles as well. And Drew now. Wait a minute. Where's the guy here? Oh, backdrop driver. Just planting Chad Gable on the back of his neck, but just a one count he gets. And now Cena, oh, he's middle of the ring, is AJ Styles gonna go for the five knuckle shuffle. You can't see me. Little shuffle, right on the money with that five knuckle shuffle. And you can see Chad Gable with a perfect plex. And now, ball game. And that is it, but Chad Gable back inside the ring. And of course, you don't see Vince McMahon out here right now, because of course he has to kind of run a company, but nevertheless, when he gets the time, he will be out here in future matches. But of course, to know tag team matches, can't really have a manager, so you know how it is. Nevertheless, Chad Gable rolls to the outside, gonna meet him out there is John Cena. Drew Gulak now has AJ Styles, and a big time splash, but he misses. Out of the way is AJ Styles. And now, a stiff shot there, but on the outside, Cena. Gonna hook him up for a single underhook suplex. And he's gonna try to help out. Oh, he doesn't need any help. Drew Gulak with a Northern Lariat on AJ Styles. AJ Styles now in a handicap situation. Oh, what the hell was that? What's going on there? They're making love. Nevertheless, Styles catches him into the Styles Clash. But Gulak, go for a clothesline reversed. Now gonna go for the cover is AJ Styles. Gable trying to stop Gulak, but no avail. And now goes for the cover after that hit scissors, but no. And now the calf crusher, the calf killer by Styles. Now, nice neckbreaker there by Gable. keeping Drew Gulak at bay here. Cena is able to get out of that calf killer. Now Chad Gable on the outside with a combination. Picks up Gulak and slams it on the outside. Now Cena with those punches right to the face. Nothing pretty about that. You see, oh, another AA goes for the cover. One, two, and Gable's there to break it up. Somehow making in time. And now a DDT, no, Gable reverses a few shots to the midsection. And now these fans are happy to get this match here between two exciting teams with two very similar dynamics. Nice takedown by Gulak. Cena and Gulak in control in this matchup right now. And now Gable gets back inside the ring. Oh, kind of interrupted what Cena was going for. And now Styles. Oh, look at this. Oh, look at this. Gulak with a power bomb. Now Styles. He got him hooked up. And oh. And for both of these teams, oh, wait a minute. Gulak, but oh, Gable there to break it up. Like I was saying, you know, both these teams are vying for that number one spot for the Raw Tag Team Championships, and we don't even know what the situation is with the Raw Tag Team Champions. Are they going to be defended? Wait a minute! Poison Rana by Gable! Unbelievable move, and he's going after Cena, but Cena with an elbow. Now into the back suplex. Now Luthez by Cena. Like I was saying again. So we have this dynamic of, two champions or a set of champions that don't really like each other in Damian Priest and Rey Mysterio. Like I said before, we're going to get to that Rey Mysterio win in just a little bit here. A little shenanigans happen there. But nevertheless, like, what is the deal with the number one contendership going on? We don't really have a real number one contender. And even if we do, are they going to have the championship match at SummerSlam? And if they do, you got to think they have a good chance of, you know, working at that dynamic of those two guys not liking each other and maybe easily capturing the Raw Tag Team Championships. We'll have to see what the deal is with the Raw Tag Team Championship match at SummerSlam. We'll have to see. Now Gulak and AJ Styles going at it. Back and forth here between these two men. Someone was busted open. I did not see who that was. I think it was maybe John Cena? Yes, it is. Look at the left side of his face. And Cena is not happy. I think AJ Styles did that to him on the outside. He's going to go for a trip. A third AA. Exploder by Gable. Ooh, counter there by AJ Styles. And now, STO almost by Cena. Oh, look at this. Now combination from AJ Styles. And that's vintage AJ Styles. Classic move. Classic combo by the phenomenal AJ Styles into a DDT onto Gulak, going for a cover. And now Gulak is busted open on the right side of the face. So half of a Crimson Mask on Cena and half of a Crimson Mask on Gulak. And now AJ Styles with a pump handle gut buster. And Cena, I thought he was going to roll out, but he's going to go back into the apron. And Gable, he's going to size him up into that spear. You know, there's a chop block by Gulak, taking down Styles, but Gable's right there to back up his partner. And now both guys are inside the ring. Both veterans are outside. Wait a minute. Going for something. No counter. Boom, Gable! Into a DDT. Goes for the cover. One, two, and no. Gulak with the shoulder up. And now both veterans are back inside. Now another calf killer by AJ Styles. Could we see a victory here? Gable just not helping out his partner. I don't know if he's dazed and confused. I'm not sure what happened there, but this match rolls on. Oh, Cena with a shot to the midsection. Drop kick by Styles. Look at this. Oh, into the neck breaker. And then, oh, springboard phenomenal forearm by Styles. And now look at Cena. Cena gonna go for a suicide dive on the Gable. What a match. And this is all just for just moving up in the rankings of the Raw Tag Team Championships. And could you imagine what these teams would do for the championship? Nevertheless, back on the outside. And there's a Hurricane Rana by Cena. And into the table goes Gulak. Now into the ring goes Gulak. Styles not going to help out his partner. Both guys going after each other. They saw that they were free and standing. There is a Northern Light suplex on the outside from Styles. He's going to go after Gulak, the man he threw inside the ring. You see, oh, nice crossbody and a nice takedown by both members of the same team. And now power by Cena, picking up Gable and planting him with a powerbomb. And now Gulak, maybe trying to go for that Gulak, but wait a minute. Oh, swing from John Cena, the air raid crash. Maybe that was a swing instead. I mix them up all the time. But there is that fisherman suplex. Well, Cena and Gulak team are ruining this match right now. Both guys working over the other team very well here. And now, oh, through the leg of AJ Styles, or from AJ Styles. And oh my God, going after the knee of Cena. And now, wait a minute. Cena gets caught into a second Styles clash. And now Cena going for the pin is AJ, but again, Gable is not helping out his partner. It seems he was too invested in John Cena. But nevertheless, Gulak breaks up into a snap suplex on Gable. And now another snap suplex. Now this time from AJ Styles. And now Cena going to go after Gable, another crossbody. This match has been non-stomp, relentless action. Endless action from these two teams. And now, what a German suplex on the outside. Now inside the ring, Argentine neckbreaker from Gulak. And now, look at this. Gulak gonna wait. We're gonna get back to his feet. Gulak on this AJ Styles. Gable is doing a Cena, but Styles has to tap out. And wow, Cena and Gulak are your winners. Unbelievable victory.
Here are your winners, Drew Gulak and John Cena.
They are beaten, they are bruised, they are bleeding, but they are winners here on Monday Night Raw. But I was talking about before, Rey Mysterio got a victory earlier on tonight against Masse. And this is how it went down. Masse was beaten over Rey Mysterio, but Damian Priest actually was trying to make the save for Rey Mysterio. These guys have been at each other's throats the whole time, but it was all just a ruse as Damian Priest got some revenge from last week from Rey Mysterio, just screwing him over in the tag team match. And that led to Rey Mysterio getting a win over Masse via disqualification. And then backstage, all these women are now attacking. We see these bad blood between all these women here. The damage control, Bayley, Dakota Kai, and Sonya Deville, and of course, Katana Chance and the women's world champion here on Raw, Becky Lynch. Well, it's a 3-on-2 assault. We don't even see Dakota Kai. I don't know where she is. But Bayley, Becky Lynch, Katana Chance, Sonya Deville, just fighting in the back here. Well, earlier last month, we saw that Becky Lynch and Bayley were fighting in the back. So this was a continuation of that. These girls, these women, just have bad blood towards each other, and they're not stopping. The ring won't stop. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, there's Dakota Kai. That's Alba Fire. Formerly Kaylee Ray. Now Alba Fire here on Monday Night Raw, and they're fighting. So it looks like Becky Lynch, Katana Chance, has a little bit of backup in Alba Fire. Oh my God. And Bayley just working over Becky Lynch with that shovel, and looks like Sonya Deville might have a bat. And there's a disarmer from Becky Lynch. Well, the bad blood's not stopping. The animosity is still there. Oh, wait a minute. Look at this! Gory bomb from Alba Fire. And these women, something has to be done between these six women. Remember, Alba Fire had a rivalry with Bayley in the first month here in a universe mode, so there's still bad blood there as well. And there's a belly to belly on the shovel. Well, we gotta get security back there. What's going on? Oh, there you go. Those women separated. We need a certain thing to rectify that, but Nevertheless, we're moving on to our main event match here on Monday Night Raw. It's going to be Ludwig Kaiser going one-on-one with our WWE Champion in Drew McIntyre.
The following is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring, representing Imperium from Hamburg, Germany, weighing in at 220 pounds, Ludwig Kaiser!
With Imperium falling behind him, Ludwig Kaiser will try to get an upset victory over the WWE Champion. Imperium are 2-2 here in tag team action, but Ludwig Kaiser, I think this might be his actual first singles matchup. Let me take a look here at my notes. Ludwig Kaiser is 0-0. That's right. He is not in a singles match yet, and he is getting plunged into the main event against the WWE Champion. And there is Gunta, who is trying to scratch and claw his way to the WWE Championship. And with Ludwig Kaiser and Giovanni Vinci behind him, he might just do just that. You know, ever since coming to 2K23, he has sort of a fire lit under him. He is 2-2, so he's trying to climb the ranks here. We'll see what happens in the next coming weeks and months here in Universe Mode. But here comes the WWE Champion. And shall I say, the undefeated 5-0 WWE Champion. His name is Drew McIntyre. With sword in hand, he is ready for battle here in the main event of Raw. And he has a chip on his shoulder when it comes to the number one contender in Edge.
And his opponent from Ayr, Scotland, weighing in at 254 pounds, the WWE Champion, the Scottish Warrior, Drew McIntyre.
Drew McIntyre has been trying to show respect to the Radar Superstar Edge in the last few weeks after their match at Payback, but the fact of the matter is Edge has wants nothing to do with it. If you want to guys get reminded about last week, if you guys remember, Edge and Sheamus had a one-on-one, banger match, if you don't mind. They had a classic match here in the main event, and after the match, Sheamus and Butch would try to attack and injure Edge, but Drew McIntyre made the save. But after that, Edge would just cheap shot Drew McIntyre right in the square in the face of Drew McIntyre. I don't know how he feels about that. I don't know what his feelings are, but he has to be seething. And I don't want to be Ludwig Kaiser right now. The man, the champion that Drew McIntyre is, if he shows respect to you, I think you got to take it. But Edge, maybe that's just him playing mind games. What a spine buster from Drew, too. No. But nevertheless, Drew McIntyre trying to show respect to the people that, you know, kind of fight him in battle. You know, he garners the people that fight him in battle and, you know, bring him to his limit. He garners his respect. Nice cross body by Ludwig, but no, just a two count. But Edge wants nothing to do with the so-called respect from the champion. All he wants is another shot at that championship. And Edge, I mean, you heard it here from himself. I mean, he was very, you know, just beating himself up because he knows that he didn't bring his A-plus game. Wait a minute, hold on. Drew McIntyre with a gut-wrench powerbomb on the outside. He didn't bring his A-plus game to Payback. And that's what led to Drew McIntyre retaining that championship. And, you know, Edge was not that happy, that satisfied with his performance. So, Edge, I mean, he is 4-2 now, so he is technically the number one contender. But nevertheless, oh my god, what a clothesline. Edge wanted to prove to himself that you know, he could bring that A-plus game. And I think that match with Sheamus kind of lit a fire under Edge. And I think he's ready for another shot at that championship. I think Edge is doing Edge things. I think he's the ultimate opportunist. What a tilt-a-whirl kind of face buster by Ludwig Kaiser. But nevertheless, I think Edge is just playing, you know, mind games like he does, being the ultimate opportunist, trying to get under the skin of the champion. I don't think Edge necessarily disrespects Drew McIntyre for being the champion and the man that he is. I just think he's trying to get under his skin so he has that certain mental advantage, maybe going to the next championship matchup. And now, look at this. Oh my God, there's the air raid crash from Ludwig Kaiser, putting on a show here against the champion too. No. But Drew McIntyre being, you know, the kind of, I guess, noble champion. I mean, he wants the people that he fights to kind of, you know, show the same respect that he does to them. But sometimes you just can't have that. Oh, right on the nose. I think he might have busted the nose open of Drew McIntyre here. And Ludwig Kaiser showing that he can hang with the big boys here. And now he's going to go for a suicide dive onto the champion. And now Ludwig, going for a clothesline is Drew. Actually, it wasn't the nose. It was actually the forehead of Drew McIntyre. I thought he was holding his nose after that face plant from Kaiser. Now look at this. Oh, wait a minute. Into a Future Shock DDT. That could be it for Kaiser. 1-2, no. And look at this. Oh, Guta. Now distracting Drew McIntyre. He wants to help out his Imperium brother. Now look at this. Throwing Drew McIntyre into the middle of the ring. That kind of reverse exploder. 1-2, and no. Champion gets the shoulder up. And now look at this. On the Ludwig Kaiser going to the top. We saw him do a suicide dive. He's going to go for an elbow drop on the back now. High risk, high reward maneuver. Now look at this. Oh, enziguri by the champ. And Drew McIntyre just so fast for his size. Oh, going for a claymore. Gets it flush. Ludwig Kaiser might be on another planet right now, but no. He gets the shoulder up. And of course, this close to SummerSlam, Drew McIntyre doesn't want to have the chance of an injury, but he needs to put away Ludwig Kaiser here and now, going for another air raid crash. And Kaiser, he might be on the cusp of a victory, an underdog victory, over the champion. And look at this, just picks him up, and into a backbreaker. And now look at this, going for another Future Shock DDT! And Ludwig Kaiser close to the ropes, so it doesn't have the ropes. 2-3, and Drew McIntyre with the victory. Kaiser, you can see clutching his neck.
Here is your winner, the Scottish Warrior, Drew McIntyre!
What a victory, and still undefeated. Heading into SummerSlam is Drew McIntyre. And he puts everyone on notice, and he puts especially Edge on notice. What a victory for the champion. Well, it looks like Drew now has a microphone. Oh my, you've just heard the challenge put out by the champion to the challenger. Hell in a cell. 2 out of 3 falls. The champion is not messing around. He wants to end this at SummerSlam against the Rated R Superstar. And the match is official. Edge has agreed to it. 2 out of 3 falls. Hell in a Cell match. This is going to be hell of a main event. No pun intended. But guys, that'll do it for me. Hope you guys enjoyed. And I'll see you on SmackDown.